Greetings, everyone. This is Lightstar, and I want to do something very special today, which is do a very special card reading using my own creation, the Magical Dimensions Oracle Cards and Activators. These cards are so powerful, and they carry a lot of energy. So I wanted to use the cards and also have you see a visual. So you're not seeing me in this video this time, but you will be seeing the images themselves. And I really wanted to do a little bit of an expanded card reading, as I normally do this on Facebook every now and again, and I will put up one card for the reading. But this time I'm doing a three-card spread. And these are images about the energies of what's going on for a lot of us in the collective viewpoint, so that there are things going on the planet and in our lives, in our personal lives. So I want to talk about some of these energies and some of the things that may be very unique individually, but also meaning for the whole, and that we need to shift into these energies a bit more. So let's get started. So the first card that I was choosing from the deck is called the Throat Portal. Now, the Throat Portal has three main words that are associated with it, and this is about speaking your truth, courage, and suppression. Now, this is meaning a lot of us have been suppressing our voice, okay, our speaking the truth. We hear that term a lot, and this is a lot of people on this planet have been suppressing our abilities to speak out and our capabilities to speak out, only because they have been chastised for so many centuries. You know, people being hanged or raped or killed or outcast for doing what? Speaking their truth. And just speaking, especially women who have been suppressed with their intuition and their psychic abilities, and not being able to utilize those because they were looked at as bad or as, you know, witches and, you know, devil's work and whatever you want to call it. Well, yeah, we're past that point. And there are certain points, places on the planet that still hold that old mentality, sure. But the majority of the planet that we know of and we live in today's world, we're not going to be hanged for speaking out, okay? For the most part, we're just going to be maybe chastised. Yeah, some people don't like what we're saying, and some people get, you know, either offended or something like that at what we're saying. But typically, we're able to speak what we need to speak. So this is really about, it's a time of pulling out the courage that you need to be able to speak your truth and your divine truth, and bringing in the will of the Creator through your voice. And some of you are extremely repressed and unable to speak even about what you really truly feel inside. And this energy of this card is saying, we need you to speak up. We need you to be in the truth and the light of who you truly are. It's a point in a time that we can no longer hold back. We can no longer do this. How much thyroid conditions are on the planet right now, particularly in women, because of these issues? So it's now time to kind of put that in the past. Okay, so we need you to step up. We need you to be courageous and stop suppressing all this energy that's going internally and causing some physical illnesses as well. We, on the flip side of that, also want to say there are some people that are a little bit, well, let's say, more outspoken, and there are some people that speak a little bit too much, too loudly, too difficult, you know, too much energy there. So we want to actually have those people take a little bit of a rest. Because maybe you guys have just been, you know, your energy is like excessive in that throat chakra and you need to calm it down a little bit. So knowing the balance and the place right here is very important, okay? So that is the first card of the Throat Portal. And you can also work with some crystals. I have a booklet that I created, and if you purchase the Magical Dimensions cards, that has the booklet in here. And there's a couple of crystals you can work with, which is blue lace, agate, and turquoise, which is really good for this area, as well as peppermint oil. So these are a few suggestions that you can look for that. So now we move on to the second card, which is Celestial Assistance. And what a beautiful thing this is, okay? We have the three main keywords here are angelic messages, guidance, and enlightenment. And this card is all about the angels. It's all about that higher vibration, bringing in the higher vibration in from the angelic messengers. You know, we're needing to speak up and speak out and speak our truth. But sometimes we actually need some help in that area, right? It's difficult to just step out there and do that. And calling upon the angels is one way of doing this. It's extremely powerful. And to bring in their beautiful messages, and they're just waiting for you. Remember, angels can't really intervene into your life unless you ask them for assistance. They are not going to, they're around you. Everyone has personal angels around them. And they're definitely going to be helping you. Your guardian angel is keeping you from, you know, falling off the face of the planet too soon when it's not your time. But you also have this time period of really connecting with your angels if you choose to use them, utilize their help on an everyday type of experience. And some people don't even know that they're there. I always call, there's so many unemployed angels. I've heard that term before. And it's so true, because they're just there waiting for you. And they can help you speak out and help you to have the courage and help you to do anything in your life that you're really needing to help, you know, with. They can help you move your life forward. They can help you release work that you need to. They can help you to step into more joy. All of these things. But just being aware that they're there, and to align with the angels, most importantly. So really want to help you in this area, because this is a big, I get this a lot in my session work, where people are having trouble connecting to other spirits or beings around them, their spiritual guides, their angels, and even their higher self. So it's really common. So there's a couple of also crystals that you can use, angelite, apophyllite, and also the essential oil of white angelica can be very helpful. So we want you to connect with the angels and have the courage to step up and to be who you are and have them help you to be more in line with you and your energy of your own soul. So now I'm gonna move into the next card, which is a really interesting one. This one is called the Guardians. And you know, I have to say, well, lately this card has been coming up for not only a lot of people that I've been doing session work for, but it also came up, as you look on my Facebook page, I had it posted there because it was coming up for the collective as well, even a month or so ago. At the time of this recording, and it's coming up again. And the three main keywords for this is shielding, defense, and warning. And what this card is, it's the reason why it's coming up so much is because there is really so much, and we're still going through this process of having to shield our energy, having to heal our bodies. We're having a lot of things affect our bodies in the atmosphere, the environment that we live in is affecting us. We're being a little bit more exposed to a lot of damaging, harmful organisms, things floating around in the air. All this stuff is kind of big. We're getting bombarded, and our immune system needs a little bit of a help here. So it keeps coming up. And again, this is also helping you to stand stronger in who you are. So you speaking, you know, being able to speak your truth and connecting with the angels. Well, now we bring it into, okay, how do I take care of this body? How do I take care of my energy and the emotional things going on around me, the toxic emotions also that are in our environment and in our own personal lives with our friends and our family and things that they're going through. And we're experiencing that. And those of you empaths, intuitive empaths out there, which I have a strong affinity for because I am one, so I completely understand this is a very challenging time for the people who are very sensitive to energy and other people's energy and tend to absorb their energies into their body. So this is a time for you to do a lot of clearing and cleansing and being kind to yourself and learning how, learning your boundaries. Where are your boundaries? And for one thing, do you have any boundaries? Because a lot of you just don't even have boundaries up there. Do you need them? Yes, you do need them down here. You know, in the higher realms, yeah, we don't need that. And we don't need to hear as much if we're truly and fully in alignment with ourselves and we completely understand who we are and the boundary line between our energy and someone else's energy, and we can be like the Buddha and the Christ down here. Yes, that's what we're ultimately trying to do so that it doesn't affect us so much. But in the interim, yeah, we have to learn about ourselves, learn about our boundaries. How much can you take, you know, in your life? How many, you know, how many hours could you be around somebody? Don't push yourself if it's too much. You might need to pull back and take some rest time for yourself. So do that. And listen to the warning signs around you. You know, a lot of you ignore what's happening around you. And this is very important to look. Your spiritual guides, even your angels, your higher self will always be giving you little hints, little messages, and things for you to look at and take care of. If there's something, a leak in your energy and in your aura, you need to take a look at that. So look at how it is with other people and what's around you and what's coming in. Some really helpful things for this, crystal wise, or rock, those rock hounds out there. Use black obsidian, smoky quartz. I know that there's a really favorite of mine, which I love, which is not in the booklet, but is shungite, and tourmaline is another, black tourmaline. These are all really great to help build your stamina and to help shield the energy around you. So these are some things that I have just been seeing, and my cards are showing these things coming out that people need to work on. So A, standing in your truth and stepping up and being courageous to speak your truth and of who you are. Asking for help from the angels to help you in your daily life, to do anything you wish to do, but to help clear the energy, to help bring in assistance where you need it, the right person at the right time, the right situation, new opportunities, whatever it might be. And then taking care of this body and taking care of you. One thing I did want to mention about the shielding is that sometimes it's a little bit of too much defense. So this card can also signify you might be doing a little bit too much defending of yourself and you got too many walls up. You've heard that term, right? Too many walls up, too many guards around your heart, for instance. And you might need to take a look at how can I be a little bit more engaging without defending my every single thing and not letting anyone in my life to love and to help me. So just a little thing I forgot about there. So anyways, this is my threefold little reading for this moment. And if you'd like to purchase my Magical Dimensions Oracle cards, they are for sale at the moment on my website at lightstarcreations.com, and you can go there and check out all of my sessions as well. I can work with you more intensely and more personally with my starseed alignment sessions, which are going into deep clearings of things that you need to move into your path, as well as DNA analysis of your star origins, your angelic origins, your elemental origins, your heritage. And so I read the DNA there and will help to kind of bring also some new energies on into your life, the new templates, and to connect you a bit more with your higher self, do releasing work, connect your divine feminine or your divine masculine, whatever it is that you might need. And you can check those sessions out also, as well as my alignment jewelry. And so please let me know if you have any questions as well on those sessions. And it's been my pleasure to serve you in this way. I send you all light and love and blessings. And I want you to be in your strength, be in your higher self, looking at the higher perspectives in all ways. Blessings and namaste.